Hello! Happy Friday, everybody! Now, you guys know this, we're dressed just casual. I'm in my like leisurely like nightwear with my nightshades because all the days are all mixed up. Today's Friday, I know. Sir Dale rolled into it in his leisurely robe. He still has sunglasses because he doesn't know what time it is. What time is it?
Is it 4 in the morning?
I don't know. 4 in the morning? Noon?
Is it noon?
1?
4 a.m.
What day?
Oh, we got Cookie Monster.
Oh.
Oh, and then we have Nacho Libre.
I sleep with this on.
Yes. Nacho Libre is in the house.
Sleeping mask.
Yeah. Okay, so Friday's going to be like casual day. We're like in our just like, you know, fun. We're just like, Friday's going to be just all about fun because remember, it's been a long week for all of you guys, long week for us. You know, I know a lot of you guys are like AP classes, like all my high school students, you guys are AP classes. And I know it's how stressful you guys have been. So today we're just gonna loosen up. We're just gonna have like a little dance off for the first, like, you know, 5, 6, 7 minutes. We got Nacho Libre in the house. We're Sir Dale in his leisurely robe. Okay. Literally, I think he just got up. Okay. I think he literally just got up. Okay. And I'm here because it's so bright in here. I've got to wear my sunglasses, okay? So, tunes, we're going to warm up. Okay, so everyone, make sure you guys have enough room. We want to see you boogie down, okay? Let's go. Let's get famous. Here we go. Ready? Go for it.
Dance party warm up.
You heard me in the call.
I start up.
Oh, come on, in the call. Get the shot.
Before I go. Hard.
Go. Let's go. Oh my God, Austin! Ready, man!
Yes! Yes, he did! Oh, we're in the fight!
Yeah! Come on, get up!
Stay with
get up! Come on, good time! Come on!
Yes!
Woo! Oh, girl! Oh, yes!
Girl! Turn it, man. I love it! Stay with us!
Woo!
Break
it down.
Yeah! It's a house party
Get some water. Thank you. Movie magic in the house. On Fridays, you guys can wear your sunglasses. I know sometimes people go and say, hey, why are you wearing your sunglasses in the house? My answer, why not? Why not? Huh? What else do you have going on today? You're stuck at home. Okay. Put them on. If you have sunglasses, put them on. Put them on. If you have these, go grab them, put them on. Okay? Come on. Good. Go ahead, get some water real fast. All right. Now, don't forget. Don't forget, Ma'am Nicole's on the computer. She's live right now, live chatting with you guys. So, remember, make sure you guys log in. Make sure your video feed is on. Okay? So, that's the right way she can know. She knows who you are. Okay? Because some of your screen names are different than, like, the names we call you guys here. So, like, your parents might have set up, like, a custom name or something. So, make sure we can see your face. That's how Ma'am Nicole is recording you, your name, so that we know how many times you've checked in. Okay? So, remember, each time you guys check in, well, Ma'am Nicole is counting all your classes. So, by the time you guys come back, okay, you should be ready to test for your next belt. Which doesn't matter if you're an advanced student or like a beginner student. We're trying to cover all of it, okay? And remember, every day we've been really focused on technique. Technique is like super important. So, you know, whether you're like really big, whether like you're really skinny or tall or short, remember, good technique always wins. Okay, so I don't want you guys to think if you're like a shorter person and you think, oh my gosh, like everyone's normally bigger than me, everyone's like normally stronger than me. Remember, if you have good technique, I'm a pretty good guesser. I'm going to guess that you're going to win in a situation. Okay, because a person that has good technique, man, you guys are going to notice like as you guys take each class with us, okay, every week, you're going to go, whoa, I'm actually stronger now than I was when this whole virus thing started. That's the whole thing about training at home. You have nothing else to do. And literally, most of you guys wouldn't train 5 days a week, right? Unless you're like on a team sport or like you're training here every day in our after school program. Like our leaders, a lot of our leaders train every day. So, you know, that's different. But like most of you guys, you know, you guys come train here maybe 2-3 times a week. You might play some baseball or soccer or something else. But, you know, when you guys are at home training your muscles a certain way every day, you're going to notice going, you're going to go, oh my gosh, whoa. I've got some guns now. Like, oh my gosh, my abs. Whoa. Whoa, my legs. Whoa. Oh my gosh, I'm so strong. Okay, so that's the whole point about what we've been trying to cover with you guys at home. The whole thing is about muscle endurance and we're going to try to create super lean muscle tissues. I want you guys to know what we're trying, like our purpose here, you know, every time you guys check in live. Right? So that's what we're going to try to do. We're going to focus on your abs, your core strength, and trying to make you as lean and strong and fit as we can. Okay? Okay. So remember, you guys can be super, like big, like super bodybuilders. They train differently. They're trying to bulk up. And that's why they, you know, it looks cool. Like, you know, like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Come on. Like all those movies. All right. So the guys joke, but thing is, most of us are not going to build our bodies up like that. So we want our bodies to be lean, fit, And we want our muscles to be like super, like endurance, like strong as far as muscle endurance, okay? So now, the first endurance drill right now is this. So let's see if Sir Dale and Sir Eddie are gonna face each other. We're gonna try to have a little competition. They're gonna stand on one leg. So everyone stand on one leg. Now watch. So whichever leg is on the ground, okay? Whichever leg is on the ground, the opposite arm is gonna try to reach forward as far as you can. So remember, one leg is off the floor. Good, now chest, it should be up though. You're gonna put your chest up and now go squat down. But chest is, and now squat your legs now, Sir Eddie. Uh-huh, now squat forward. You're gonna try to reach each other.
Oh, okay.
There we go. Try to reach each other, but without having bad form in your backs. There we go. So you want nice straight lines. So your shoulder, your back, turn a little bit. There we go. Now just bend your leg. Uh-huh, you got bend your legs, sirs.
Like John Jones.
Yeah, and then hold, but hold. Hold, okay? Hold it, there we go. Good, so you're gonna hold. Whoa, there we go.
Feel the burn.
Good, feel the burn, so hold. So you're gonna be on one leg, and then just hold. Like, find a certain position, and then hold. There we go. There we go, keep going. Woo, I'm turning this way. Oh, my leg is starting to burn. Oh my gosh, my leg is definitely not feeling good. But hey, it's all part of the experience here on Shin's Life. Keep going, bend your legs. Bend your legs, sirs. Bend your legs at home.
Bend those legs.
Quit your whining. There's no whining. Let's go. All right, a few more seconds and time. Oh my gosh. OMG, OMG.
I felt that.
OMG, OMG, okay. All right, here we go. Switch legs. Other side, go, switch legs. Everyone switch legs. Now bend it, bend that leg. With the opposite arm, you're gonna reach out as far as you can, but without hunching your back. Don't hunch your back. There we go, your back straight. Uh-huh, you're gonna reach forward, you're gonna reach forward, reach forward, reach forward. Try to stretch everything out. Try to make each, like your arm, your line as long as possible. Make that line on your body as long as you can. Bend your legs more, so ready? More, there we go, now hold that position. Ah, see, it's not that easy, right? So bend your legs more, Sir Dale. And the other leg, there we go. The other leg should be bent. That's cool. There we go. But reach out with this arm, Sir Dale. There we go. Uh-huh. Keep that position. Muscle endurance. Mother, look at that. In this robe, he literally just woke up, I think. He did. There we go. Good. Hold it. Hold it. Why are they moving? Why are they moving?
John Jones.
Let's go. Let's go. Yeah. See, Sir Eddie's having a hard time, too. It's not just you guys at home. Him, too. Oh, bend your knees more, Sir Dale. I caught him. I caught him. Good. And now time, relax. Boom. Okay, now, watch. Now, me and Milani, come out over here because she's been helping to monitor and check people in, writing their names down. So she's going to just show you guys a horse dance. This is called a horse dance. Hold right down in front of them. Right there. Good. Now, uh-huh. Now, go show them, ma'am. Good. Now, she's going to hold, put one arm out, put both arms out, ma'am. And then she's going to follow along. She's going to do this with you guys. Okay, so. There we go, Sir Eddie, Sir Dale. Hold that position.
Double position.
There we go, there we go. Good. Uh-huh, back straight. There we go, good. Arms out, Sir Eddie. And then hold it. Good, you guys are doing this with them. Hold, yeah, look at that smile. Woo! Good times, guys. We're having good times. Keep going. Keep going, keep going. Hold. Hold.
Hold it.
Ah! Hold. Hold that position. Don't give up. Keep going. Come on, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Let's go. Hold it. Hold the position. Legs should be bent. Bend the legs. Bend the legs. Bend the legs. Hold it.
Not so low, Chloe.
No, come on, let's go. Not so low, Chloe. Tushy should be as level with your knee. See, like she stood up because she's starting to burn. It's starting to burn. Sir Dale, oh, he keeps moving too. Oh, Sir Eddie's struggling. He's sore.
I'm struggling.
Sir Eddie is so sore.
Come on, Jesus.
Sir Eddie is so sore. Keep going.
It's all right.
Come on. What do you got? Show me. Let's go. Let's go.
Back straight, Chloe.
Keep going. That's called horse dance. Don't forget it.
Come on.
Don't forget this dance. Like you're giddy up on a horse. Okay? If you guys have ever ridden horses, literally, that's like almost like what do you look like?
Back straight.
Back straight. Sir Dale doesn't have his back straight.
Back straight, Chloe.
Back straight. I think he's weighed down by his ponytail and his robe.
Caden
Ferre,
like,
his robe looks like he weighed like 20 pounds.
I think this is
bad. Hold that horse dance! Hold it! Hold it!
Welcome to
you can do it! This is called old school, baby. Old school TKD, okay? And time, good. Oh, okay, thank you, man, Hawaii. Thank you, great job. Should be great, right? Woo! Hawaii in the house, baby! Woo! Shaka! Okay, go ahead and get some water, guys. Woo! Woo! I got Manolani. Woo!
Ow, they're all like, ow.
So Friday literally is going to be like casual day. Like, okay, because remember, like, this has been a long week for a lot of you guys. Like, we have a bunch of high school kids log in right now. You know, I just feel bad because like the seniors in high school, like they won't be able to like walk and like shake hands and get their diplomas and stuff. So, you know, just be mindful of how lucky we are just to be alive. Like, even though that's like a really like I feel really bad for like Sir Ryan, he's graduating, right? So he was supposed to walk this in June and stuff. So, you know, I feel bad for all of our senior high school students, and I feel bad for all of you because I know how much you guys all miss your friends and that contact. You know, all like, you remember, you guys can still text. So, you know, if you guys are like talking to your friends, start like calling them, like maybe just to see their face, like, hey, you know, like, dude, how you been? Like, hey, how you been? Like, right? Okay. So instead of just texting, like, maybe once in a while, just, you know, try to like FaceTime them or like, you know, like send them a funny picture of you doing whatever, like a selfie or something, or whatever, you know, like stay connected though. Like, you know, just texting is cool, but like to see people's face and to see their reaction as you're talking to them, that's the connection you don't want to lose. Okay, so like I've been FaceTime, like I've been saying, you guys, telling you guys, I've been FaceTime my parents all like every day. I love seeing their face, and like I'm cracking jokes and they're cracking jokes back, and I can just see their like expression. It's like a beautiful thing. So, you know, if you guys are fortunate enough to have grandparents still living, you guys, they would probably love for you guys to FaceTime them or Skype them or just, you know, just to talk to them so they can see your face and then you can see their face. And, you know, that's how we should be right now during this really weird time. Okay, so now. So you guys should be loosened up now from all that like dancing and like, okay. Okay, so now Sir Eddie is just gonna go through like a very simple like punch kick combo. Go ahead, Sir Eddie.
All right, sweet. So guys, usually when you're in your stance, you're either like, I'm sorry, I'll get back a little bit. Sorry. Like left foot forward or right foot forward. But like, I want you guys to think about like a dart. This is called the dart, okay? A lot of boxers use it.
What's it called, sir?
The dart.
The dart, oh, like a dart. Like you're shooting a dart.
And it's usually like when you feel like you're cornered or your back's against the rope. So look, all I'm doing is for my feet, I'm just going to shoot my right hand, but I want you guys to change angles. So I'm shooting, changing angle. Okay.
Ooh, that was cool.
Then you're going to fire your kick out. Like a lot of you guys can do this. It's very easy for you, right? So if I'm far away, look, I'm just going to dart, move, and then kick. Okay. We do it a lot. It's called like when we get off center on our back. So I want you guys to focus, keep your feet like this, okay? And you're darting your right hand out. So I'm gonna dart, move, kick.
Ooh, that was cool. Okay. Show them again, sir. Same angle, please, that was awesome.
Yes, sir. So you're like this, try to keep a little rhythm too, okay? So you're like this, you're gonna dart, move, and then kick. Follow through with your kick. Or you can hold like chamber kick, okay? If you like, but most importantly, just dart, move. Practice that a little bit, and then throw the kick.
Okay, you guys got it? Now, remember, this is all new to Sir Dale too, so, you know, they're going to take turns, like, doing a certain movement or a technique, and it's going to be new to Sir Eddie, like Sir Dale's been doing a lot of donkey kicks and, like, you know, X-outs and stuff like that, and handstands, so Sir Eddie doesn't normally get to practice that kind of stuff, so this is a good time for you guys to all cross-train. So we have all types of students right now watching. We have, like, our kick and flippers, our, like, demo performance team kids watching right now. We have our black belt students watching right now. We have our students getting ready for their black belt test, so we're going to try to cover as much different material as possible, like as many different things as possible, so that we stay well-rounded, okay? So even though you guys all have like a specialty, because like certain kids like love safeguard and only do safeguard, and that's cool, and that's, we love that, but since you guys are all at home, why not cross-train? Because we have to try to teach all of our students, right? So we're going to cover like handstands today, we're going to cover X-outs again, I think we did that yesterday, okay? So we're going to try to make this as advanced as possible, but in a progression based. So like step one leads to step two, leads to step three. Okay, so follow along. Just, you know, just make sure you guys breathe out with that punch, that dart punch, right? It's a fake, almost like a fake. And then the other leg comes around, you change directions, and then you throw your roundhouse kick, okay? Keep going. Great job, everybody. Great job. Okay, great job. these sunglasses are actually blocking out a lot of the lights here. So we've gotten a little technical here with our Shin's live class. We have like light set up.
Thanks to Chloe.
Yo, yeah, that's right. Thanks to Chloe's dad. Thank you so much, sir. Yay, Chloe's dad. Thank you so much for letting us borrow your things. Okay, so great job. Awesome. Keep going. A few more seconds and on time. Now, Sir Dale is going to just warm you guys up with like a gymnastics movement. Okay, go ahead, sir.
Fight. We're going to continue what we've been doing this week. We're going to do our donkey kicks, okay?
Check out the robe, everybody. Check out the robe.
When you guys do your donkey kicks, remember, both of your feet have to jump up into the air at the same time. Don't do one foot at a time. Otherwise, it's a handstand. So once you jump your feet up into the air, catch yourself on your hands, and then as soon as you feel your feet about to come down, push the ground away and snap your feet down. So jump both feet onto your hands, push the ground away. Got it?
One more time, sir.
One more time. You're gonna jump on your hands, push the ground away, and snap your feet.
So you're gonna push the ground away, everybody. Okay, on your own for 20 seconds. Ready, go. Make sure that no one's around you guys. Practice on your own. Take your time. So when you guys are practicing your donkey kicks, make sure that you have enough room around you, okay? You don't want to kick furniture. You don't want to kick your brother or sister. There we go. Good. Take your time, Sir Dale. Good. Sir Eddie, you good? Take your time. I think they're getting a little tired.
I feel like I'm getting better at it.
Good. Catch your breath. Take your time, guys. Take your time. Okay? Good. And time. Catch your breath. Breathe. Catch your breath. Breathe. Good. Breathe. Remember, we have like different level students watching right now, live right now. We have our beginners. We have our intermediate students, our advanced students. So remember, all the advanced students, my leaders, my black belts, remember, this has been like, you know, some of this stuff is kind of easy for you. So on the things that are easy for you, you guys can modify it by how hard you're going through the movement. Okay, so even though you might throw just like a simple uppercut or a hook, remember there's intensity involved. So the higher belt you are, the more advanced you are, you should be more intense than, let's say, our white belts or yellow belts, okay? All right, now, Sir Eddie's gonna throw you guys into the combo. Okay, so pay close attention. Go ahead, Sir Eddie.
Sweet, so just like how when you guys are moving, like I know sometimes it's like right-handed, left-handed. I want you guys to get used, what is it, ambidextrous?
Ambidextrous.
I know you guys are out there.
Ambidextrous, right? Ambidextrous.
Try to go with your movement. If I'm like this, look, I'm gonna walk through it with you guys. I'm gonna go one, so now when I hop, okay, now I'm gonna use my left hand as my cross. Then I'm gonna go the other way. So you can kind of play with the angles, okay? So what I'm doing is, I'm crossing, moving back, okay? So one, here.
Get a little closer, sir.
Here.
There we go, now show them. Okay.
Go a little slow, guys, look.
So watch him again, watch what he's doing.
Okay, I'm here, my hands are
watch
up.
What he's doing.
I'm going one, and then from this back foot, I'm just jumping, okay? And then now this hand goes out, okay? And I'm going back, okay? It's almost like you're surfing, check your balance, okay? So when you get really like motion with it, like just relax. So I'm here, one, two, okay? And then move around a little bit.
There we go, keep going. Do it with him, guys, go ahead, go with him. Now, while you guys are following along, Sir Dale's gonna join you guys too. Because like I said before, remember, some of this stuff is new to Sir Dale, some of this stuff is new to Sir Eddie. They're both cross-training, okay? Okay, so it's really good at cross-train. So like, let's say you're really good at football, or you're really good at soccer, or you're really good at gymnastics. The way you cross-train is gonna be what your sport is, okay? So right now, like tumbling and gymnastics and martial arts are, they complement each other very well. That's why like martial artists are usually like really good, like they're either good break dancers or like just they have really good rhythm and timing. So anything with physical movement, you guys can use to complement whatever sport you're involved in. Okay, right? So when you guys are at Shin's, you're involved in like safeguard, kick and flip. That's like, we try to cover everything while you guys are here. So while you guys are at home, that's what we've been trying to do, is cover a little bit of everything so that you maintain your core strength, number one, right? Your flexibility, right? Number one. And then also, right? Training this, okay? So by cross training, Sir Dale and Sir Eddie are both cross training. You just keep your body really fit. And then when you come back, you can, if you are a specialist at a certain area here at Shin's, whether it's like kick and flip or the trampolines or your advanced tumbler, or you're like one of our leaders or one of our black belts, right? Or black belt prep students. Okay, you can go back and doing that too. Okay, but for right now, we're all gonna be at home. We're all gonna cross train, okay? Keep going. Breathe, 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 relax, relax.
So Chief
relax.
Says he respects the robe.
Oh, so Chief says he respects the robe. Nice comments, Achieve. Don't forget, Mam Nicole's live. So if you guys want to give a funny shout out, whatever that might be, give us a shout out. We'll say your name out. If you don't want us to say your name, if you want just to give us a regular shout out, whatever. Okay? Let's have fun. Friday's going to be fun day. Okay? Keep going. Now time. Relax. Good. Everyone go ahead and get some water. Go, go, go. I saw some of you guys go ahead and reach for your water. So go ahead and get some water. Good. So, are you good?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you good? Yeah, all right.
Good.
Woo! Good. Breathe. Breathe. Shorty's trying to get a good sweat.
Yes.
He's got his body, he's got his hoodie on. But Sir Dale looks so comfortable. Huh?
Yes.
He looks very comfy. Whoa, like he just got off like from the couch with a remote or something, or like, no. You know? Right? All right, here we go. So now Sir Dale's going to take over for another move, okay?
All right, the second part of what we've been doing all week is the handstand. You got to continue doing that over and over to get better at it. So as we talked about before, you want to keep a straight line all the way from your hands through your body to the back of the leg. So when you're going down, you keep that straight line all the way through. Once your hands hit the ground, use this top leg right here to swing up and then hold your balance, okay? Strong core, swing up, feet together. One foot at a time, catch yourself with one leg, finish with your hands up.
Yay! Okay, now, I know a lot of you guys are at home right now saying, oh, this is like pretty easy. So just, if the handstand is really simple for you, just really control like how you are when you're upside down. Make sure that your both legs are straight together, right? Your knees are like locked out, not bent. So there's ways to make things harder to challenge yourself if you're one of our advanced students. Now, if handstands are kind of new to you, just take your time. We don't want you guys to get hurt, so you don't have to kick as high. But try to make sure that the one leg, like Sir Dale was showing you, kicks up as high as you can safely. Okay, for 1 minute, practice your handstands. Ready, go. Now, Shreddy and Sir Dale are gonna go, they're gonna practice their handstands with you guys. Okay, so while you guys are doing this, just, I'm gonna try to talk my way through the technique so that if you guys can hear my voice, you can keep on practicing while you're listening. Okay, so all you're gonna do is post your hands straight down, right? And as soon as your body bends down, the one leg that's off the floor, your heel's gonna drive up to the ceiling. The harder you drive that heel up, the higher your body will be able to stay. Okay, so the lower you swing your heel, the shorter amount of time you'll be upside down. So if you want to be upside down for a long time, that heel that you're kicking upward, up to the ceiling, right? Upward means up, okay? That'll determine how long you're going to be able to hold your body upside down. Now, the most important thing is that you post your arm straight. If you're upside down and your arm starts to bend at all, what's going to happen is that you're going to hit your head right on the floor. Okay, and you're done, so your shoulders are gonna hurt, but you know, you don't wanna really injure your shoulders because as you get older, you're gonna really need your shoulders, okay? So make sure you guys are packing safely at home. Make sure there's no furniture around you, okay? No brothers and sisters, right? No small animals, no small babies, okay? Good, catch your breath, breathe, good, breathe. Good, catch your breath, good, breathe. Good, now Sir Eddie's gonna take over with another combination. Let's do another punch kick combo, sir.
Okay, so, the second set, you're just gonna go question mark kick. So if I'm standing like this,
question mark kick, everybody.
Like what we did last time. So like jab, level change. Okay. Now when you come up, like I want you to fake it, like fake. Okay. So I'm going 1, 2, 3.
High low kick.
Okay.
Again.
So 1.
High low. Two. High kick.
Okay.
Or you guys saw what we're doing, right? So.
Or you can throw your roundhouse.
Or roundhouse, you guys pick and choose the kick. Any kind of roundhouse is fine. Just, yeah, like what Sir Eddie said, just play around with it. Just feel it out. Some of you guys love doing certain like roundhouse kicks, like a big question mark kick. Some of you guys like your pop-ups, right? So practice your like best roundhouse kick. Change it up a little bit. So the focus is going high with your hand, then low with your hand, and then back up high with your foot. So all that is, remember, for all my low belts out there, for all my advanced students, this is like common knowledge, all you're doing is changing levels. That's all you're doing, okay? Like high tide, low tide. All you're doing with your body is changing levels. When you guys change levels, if someone that's trying to hurt you is trying to punch you or choke you or whatever, they're trying to assault you, if you change levels, it's a lot harder to physically like make contact with you. That's what we're always telling you, move, like move in a circle, change levels, because a moving object is a lot harder to grab. A moving object is a lot harder to punch. It's a lot harder to choke. It's a lot harder to kick. That's why we want you guys changing levels and switching directions. Okay, let's go. Keep going. A few more seconds. Don't stop. You guys got this. I know some of you guys are getting tired. Push through the pain. You guys can do this. And now time. Good. Catch your breath. Great job. Breathe. Everyone breathe. Catch your breath. Okay. Catch your breath. Breathe. There you go. Catch your breath again. In and out. So if you like, remember, we talked about breathing. When you guys feel like anxious or stressed out, nervous, sad, just try to like really, really focus on your breathing. Like it's a mindfulness exercise. All right. So like Mae Nicole reminded me of it. Okay. And this is really her idea, and I want to give her credit for it. So being mindful. It's about being mindful, like mindful being like, you know, really think about your center, like yourself, and just like breathe in, like feel your air, like breathe out. Feel it. There we go. It's really relaxing. It calms me down. Okay. It really does. So you should try it too. So like if it's been a long week, if you've been kind of stressed out about homework, about like not being able to see your friends, or like just about this whole thing that's going on, right? Everyone's like a little bit on edge, right? Because, you know, it's kind of, we haven't seen each other like in 3 weeks. So, okay. So if you need to, and like your body is like, you know, you're feeling a little anxious, just let it go. Just, you know, breathe in, let it go. Okay. Okay. Now, before we switch back to Sir Dell, I'm going to have Sir Eddie show you one more move, because we do have a lot of brand new people to Safeguard that have been logging in. So a lot of people that just normally do our kick and flip classes or on trampolines and our demo team. So I want you guys to know what a sprawl is, because we're going to be incorporating that a lot into the daily classes. So for all those, all of our students that really don't know like exactly how to do a sprawl yet, let's try to cover it for like the next 2 or 3 minutes. Okay. Sir Eddie, just a sprawl.
So here, I know some of you guys have a hard time like being bendy. So I'm saying like, if I sprawl, I'm kind of going like that.
It's almost like the worm.
So my hips are going back and I'm down.
Okay? It kind of is the worm.
So the second one is you can just turn your hip to the mat and pop up to your feet. Okay. So I'm here, hip to the mat.
Cool, and then up.
Then you can switch it up here. Okay. Here, or one one here.
You guys saw there's two different variations of the sprawl. So Sir Eddie just showed you both. There's the kind where you like do the worm. It's like a breakdancing move, right? But it's actual self-defense move as well. Okay, so that's the worm version. That's that worm version. And the other kind is where you just go hip straight down to the floor. Okay, show them one.
Turn.
There we go. Hip down, and then you turn your hips. So it's not like you go both hips down. It's you turn one hip. You're gonna turn, okay, but with control, while your arms are posted, controlling your body on the way down. Show them one more time, Sir Eddie, face the camera.
Sir.
So watch.
Here, hip.
Good, that's one version.
Next one is, you wanna push yourself way up.
That's two different versions, so practice both, okay? Get good at both, okay? And then Sir Dell, remember, he used to be a breakdancer. He's actually really good. So maybe, you know, maybe next week we'll have breakdancing day, and we'll have Sir Dell teach us all how to breakdance. That'd be pretty cool. Okay, so he's a really good breakdancer. So, okay, so take your time. There's two versions, don't forget. The worm version or the hip straight down version. Change direction. Make sure you guys, after you're all, like, let's say you're done with one direction, as soon as you're back up, face another way. Okay, go for it. Go, 1 minute. Go. Practice on your own. You're practicing your sprawl. Go. Practice on your own. Pace yourself. Make sure you have enough room around you. Make sure you guys are training safe. Okay, let's go. Keep going. Practice your sprawls. Yeah, I saw a bunch of worms. That's pretty cool. Yeah, we can see you guys. That's great technique. Keep going. I can see you guys. That's awesome technique. Keep going. Make sure you guys breathe out when you drop down on your sprawl. So exhale. As you catch your body in a down position, make sure you guys are exhaling. That's going to really control your body's tempo. Okay, use your exhale. So as you sprawl down to the ground, to the floor, use your breath. Exhale out. Breathe out. Okay, keep going. Let's go for like 5 more seconds. Keep going. 4 more seconds. Keep going. Let's go. Sprawl. Let's go. 2. We're going to do 1 more. And time. Good. Time. Catch your breath. Good. Everyone breathe. Breathe. Good. Breathe. Good. Deep breath.
Good job, guys.
Good. Now, we're going to have a little competition at the end of today's class. We're going to weigh Sir Dale's ponytail. If you took the last class, you're not allowed to say. Don't, you can like, okay, so I think there's a couple of you that, there's probably some of you that were here for the 4 o'clock class. If you know how much his ponytail weighs, you'll already announce it. Don't say anything, don't ruin it for everybody. Okay, so if you already know how much his hair weighs, you're not allowed to say anything. Just like you can giggle and laugh because you already know. But for the kids, for all the students that just logged on at 5 o'clock, we have a scale here. We're gonna literally weigh his ponytail. Okay, so the last class we had someone guess it. It took like, how many tries? Like 5, 6, 7?
10.
7? Like 7, 8, 9 tries, something like that. I think like it took like 7 or 8, 9 tries. Okay, so at the very end of today's class, just start thinking about, like, if you have long hair, so like some of you have like super long hair, just kind of figure out how much your own hair weighs. So so if you have longer hair, it's probably gonna be easy because I think the student that guessed has like hair up to the here. So I think she, I don't know, I think she maybe felt her own hair and see how much it weighed. So, okay, start thinking about it. Okay, all right. Okay, but not yet though, don't type it in yet. At the very end of the class, we still have 10 more minutes. So at the very end, we're gonna bring the scale on, we're gonna weigh Sir Dale's hair, and then you guys all have to guess how much it weighs, okay? But at the very end, okay? Okay, here we go. Now, Sir Dale's gonna show us another kick and flip type movement. Sir Dale?
Let's try backward roll today.
Oh, changing it up.
Yeah, why not? And when you do this, you wanna sit first. Don't fall break. So get really low, sit on your tush, and then roll onto your back. Now, what gets tricky is your neck. You don't wanna put too much pressure on your neck. So instead of letting your neck touch the ground, let your hands touch the ground. So you wanna look like you're holding two pies right there, okay? So again, you're gonna stand up, you're gonna sit really low, land on your tush, hold two pies, roll, and go.
Whoa!
Stop the roll. And now, if it's too hard, just do a shoulder roll. Just put both knees on one side.
Oh, you guys saw that, right? Right, so when Sir Dale went backwards, so Sir Eddie, show them a shoulder roll again. That was awesome, Sir Dale. You're gonna turn your head to the side. You're not gonna have your neck straight. If you shoulder roll backwards, your neck, instead of, you have to tilt your head to one side. So you're either gonna tilt your head this way, or you're gonna tilt it on the other way. You're gonna roll backwards on the side where you're not leaning. So if you're leaning your head this way, you're gonna roll on this shoulder. If you lean your head this way, you're gonna roll on this shoulder. Okay, so you're gonna roll to your open side. Okay, so make sure when you guys do this, make sure that you know what's behind you. Like what's behind you. Make sure you know what's behind you. Now you guys saw what Sir Eddie's doing. He's already doing the combination. He's going forward and back, and they're staying low. He's staying low, so he's not standing up, he's staying low, because this is, you can also use, this is also like a breakdancing move, but it's also like a wrestling move, it's also a self-defense move, so you can tell, like, you know, that's why we are dancing today, because it's a good complement to martial arts and self-defense training, it's a good complement to tumbling, right? So when you guys do this, keep your body low, your thighs, your legs aren't going to like it so much, but that's okay, right? Your abs aren't going to like you too much, your back. You're incorporating a lot of different little tiny muscles. Even though you're using large groups of muscles, this movement is using also little tiny little muscles as well. Okay, ready, go. Go, go, go. Go for it, you guys got this. Now, some of you guys are like have more room than others. If you have more room, and like if you guys, some of you guys are in the living room and I see your furniture completely cleared out. You guys, if you guys have more room, watch. Go like, if you can do like two backwards, one forward, or like two forward, one backwards. Okay, so if you don't have enough room, don't do it. Practice safely, right? So some of you guys are in your living room and you have the room. So if you have the room, and right, so go, you can mix it up though. Try not to do like backwards, backwards, backwards. Change direction. So like if you go like two backwards, then go one forward. Or if you go one, two forward, then go one backwards. Okay, don't go like three things in a row, because then that's just like defeats the purpose. There's no purpose in that. You're just gonna stand up and get dizzy. Okay? Learn how to change directions, whether it's forward and back. Okay, because remember, sometimes if you're on the ground, and let's say like the other kids or kid has like a rock in their hand and they're like throwing it at you, and you're literally on the ground, you better back roll out of it. That rock is gonna hit you. Okay, so Don't forget, a lot of these movements can translate to different situations in life, right? It might be for you're doing this move for a sport. You might be doing this move for self-defense. You might be doing this move for breakdancing. But okay, so these movements correlate to a lot of different things. Okay, because we have a lot of different athletes out there watching. We have volleyball players, we have track and field athletes, we have soccer players watching, we have football players watching right now, basketball players. Even though you guys all have the common thing of training in shins, we have a lot of kids that play other sports like swim. There's divers out there. Okay, so we're going to try to cover as many different movements so that it still translates to whatever sports you guys play in real life. Okay? Great job, guys. Great job. Great job. Great job. Good. Now, time. Good. Now, so Eddie's going to, let's see if we can use that as part of like a combination, like a self-defense combo, sir.
From the back row, let's see. Let's go like this. Look. So check this out. When you guys are doing this, like same thing, okay? Look, back roll. Now what I want you to think of doing is landing in like a half butterfly, okay? So pretty much very simple is just like I would teach you guys how to get up. I don't want to be on this side, okay? It's opposite. I want to be here like this. Then you're just going to bring your body up, step your leg back, okay? And see how like you're already loaded in your stance, whether it's like this, okay? So very simple, look, back roll. And I know some of you guys can pop up to your feet, but as I roll, this is like half butterfly. So then my hand goes up, scoot, up to your feet.
And you guys heard what he said, right? So he said, when you guys roll out of that backward roll, you're landing into like a half butterfly. Okay, so one more time. So
it's almost like a...
Okay, so watch. Remember, you're turning your head to one side, you're gonna roll back.
And then here, hand up. Okay, so now when you come up, you're already loaded. You can like Superman punch.
Okay.
Whatever.
Yeah, face cam one more time, sir, ready, and then show them again.
So here.
So watch. He's gonna shoulder roll.
Here.
He lands in a half butterfly. His hands up. Remember, one hand's up. And then he just stands up. You guys, your legs are gonna work. Like you work hard right now. Your legs are gonna burn. Okay. All right, here we go. You have the whole weekend for your body to recover. So make sure you guys take your time, though. Remember, take your time. We have a lot of beginners out there. Take your time and really focus on good technique. Okay. All right. Now, make sure you guys have enough room, because every time you guys do this, as long as you have enough room, try it facing a different way the next time. Like turn this way, try it. Right, the combination. Turn this way, try the combination. Go this way. Try it going this way. Okay, we're just gonna go for 45 seconds, okay? Ready, go. Go, go, go. You're gonna go backward roll, land in a half butterfly stance with your hand up, covering your face, and then you stand up. So it's like a lunge. It's like if you were gonna do for like a fitness class or like a PE class at school, they would consider that a lunge. You're gonna lunge up, okay? So instead of lunging down, you're already down, you're gonna lunge back up. Okay, so you're going to backward shoulder roll. You're landing in a half butterfly stance. Okay, so one foot is posted. One leg is in a butterfly stance. The hand is up, and then you stand up. Your hand that's in front of your face is your protection hand, right? That's your guard. That's part of your guard. So your guard has to be up. Okay, so the entire time. So once you guys shoulder roll backwards, right, and you land in that half butterfly stance, that hand that's in front of you has to stay there the entire time as you stand up. And then you start back down. Once you reset, you can put that hand down. But once your hand is up, it has to stay there. That's what's protecting your face. And we all know what's in your head. It's your brain. Your brain is very sensitive. It's got to be protected all the time. Okay? Keep going. A few more seconds, guys.
Vroom says that Sir Eddie looks like he's from 8 Mile.
Oh, that was awesome. Vroom says Sir Eddie looks like the dude or the guy from 8 Mile. Which is Eminem. That is hilarious.
That's awesome.
That's awesome, dude. That's funny. Okay, he kind of does look like Eminem. Okay? Okay, here we go. All right, here we go. And time. Good. Catch your breath. Catch your breath. Good, good, good. Catch your breath. Good. Breathe. 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 Okay. Good. All right. Sir Dale, next kick and flip technique.
Let's try the exhale.
One more technique, guys.
Exhale.
We're going to finish today with the exhale. Okay. Watch.
You're going to do your standard handstand. Once your feet are together, you're going to go out into a split. Out into a split, back together, and then land one foot at a time. So, feet together, legs apart, feet together.
Exhale. Oh, the robe is bringing him down.
Yeah.
You guys know what we do, right? So it's a handstand, you go straddle, and then you bring your legs back together, and then And then that's it, and you're done. And you do it again. So one more time, Sirdar. Hands up, apart, together, down. You guys saw that, right? 1 minute. Ready, go. Go, go, go. This is your final exercise for today. Go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Good. It's called an X out. So you go handstand to straddle. It's an upside down straddle. Okay? And then you bring your legs together, and then you handstand back down. Don't forget to scissor your legs up one at a time. That's going to give you the most control. We covered the basic cartwheel position already today. So now, once you guys learn how to do your cartwheels, we got to make it a little bit more challenging for you guys. And that's how we're going to do it. We're going to do it with an X out. This is also a trampoline move. You can do this with a backflip on the trampoline. It's called an X out. You can do an X out on the spring floor, okay? Which is just like a round off back tuck on the floor. You do an X out and then you land. Okay, but the way we're going to teach you how to do this at home is by doing it on the floor while you guys are doing a handstand. There's a handstand to a straddle, otherwise known as an X out, literally the X, letter X, out. Okay, and then you legs back together, then you stand back down. Great job, everybody. Great job. Keep going, keep going. And now time. Good. Everyone lay on your backs. Everyone lay on your backs. We're going to finish with some core work. Lay on your backs. Everyone lay on your backs. There we go. Good, lay down, lay down, lay down. There we go, good. So now I'm gonna mix up the different exercises, okay? So Sir Eddie and Sir Dale face each other, please.
Yes, sir.
There we go, that's cool. Okay, so you're gonna bear with me. Okay, make sure you guys can see your screens. Okay, we're gonna start with bicycle kicks. So now watch, go. Go, Sir Dale, go, Sir Eddie, bicycle kicks. Everyone go, bicycle kicks. You guys see them, right? Bicycle kicks, bicycle kicks, bicycle kicks, bicycle kicks for five, keep going. Four, bicycle kicks, three, 2, 1, good. Now, regular sit-ups for 10 seconds. Go. Fingertips up in the air. Reach up to the ceiling. Everyone, reach up to the ceiling. Let's go. Reach up to the ceiling. Let's go. Reach up to the ceiling. Air fives if you're doing with a brother or sister. High fives with your brother or sister. Keep going. Let's go. Few more seconds. Good. Now, go plank position, everybody. Plank position. Go. Everyone hold plank position. Let's go. Plank. Plank, plank, plank. Now, start doing plank jacks for 10 seconds. Go. 10 seconds of plank jacks. 10 seconds of plank jacks. Keep going. Go. You guys got this. Keep going.
My mighty
better work. Keep going. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. Now just hold regular plank. Hold regular plank. Just hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Now time. Now you're going to turn sideways. Turn sideways and face into your camera. And you're going to hold side plank. You're going to hold one arm, side plank. The other arm can be here. The other arm can be out here. You're going to hold one arm sideways. It's called side plank. Make sure that you guys use the entire forearm. Your entire forearm should be on the ground. The other arm can be here or here to maintain balance, but whichever arm is on the ground, your entire forearm should be there. Maintain body straight. Straight lines, straight lines, straight lines, straight lines. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Good, now switch sides. Switch sides. Make sure you guys can see it. There we go. Huh? Make sure you guys use good technique. Good. Your other knee can come here. Good, good, good. The entire arm should be on the ground. Breathe. Shh. Let's keep that core nice and strong. Hold it there. The entire forearm should be on the floor. Body should be straight. Body should be straight. You should only have one foot on the floor. You should have one heel on top of the other heel. Make sure you only have one foot on the floor. Squeeze that tummy, guys. Squeeze that tummy. And now time. Good. Catch your breath. Breathe. Relax. Breathe. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Catch your breath. One more. Okay. One more ab exercise. One more core exercise. It's going to be a side plank reach through. So while you guys are holding side plank, your other hand starts up high. You're going to reach through and then reach back up. The other hand, while you're holding side plank position, you're going to reach through and then reach back up. Go ahead and do that now. Go. You're going to reach through and then reach back up. So this is the arm that's on the ground. The other arm reaches down. It reaches through and then reach deep. Like this hand is going through, like it's going through a tunnel. You're an explorer. This is the exploration. It's like submarine. Take that submarine and explore deep, deep in that tunnel and then come back out with that sub. And then it resurfaces. Okay, breathe. Reach down, reach through, reach back up. If your abs, if your core is burning, you're doing this right. Keep going, keep going. Good, now switch sides. Woo, that feels good, huh? Here we go, ready? So you're gonna elbows. Remember, the entire forearm is going to be on the ground. Make sure this entire thing is on the ground. Other arm is going to reach through, deep, and then it's going to reach back and hold. You're breathing the entire time, guys. Don't forget to breathe. So you're here, you're holding plank position. This is the one side arm. Other arm is going to reach down. It's going to reach through, and then reach back up. It's going to reach down. It's going to reach through, and then back up. Keep going. Reach down. Reach through. Reach back up. Here we go again. Three more. Keep going. Actually, let's go like 10 more. Keep going. Come on. You guys can do this. Hold that position. Remember, we got a lot of advanced students here logged on right now. Most of you guys are high belts. Most of our kids logged on are leaders. Okay, there's a whole bunch of you. There's a whole, yeah, we got black belts logged in right now. Keep going. Make it burn. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. And out of time. Good. Catch your breath. Breathe. Good. Catch your breath. Catch your breath. Good, good, good. Any words in our head? Sir Dell, we all do this every day. Some words of encouragement from Sir Dell?
All right, guys. Don't even trip about what's happening right now, because there's going to be a day in the future where we get to go back outside into the world and enjoy the outside world with all of our friends, okay? And if you're ever feeling down that you're not getting anything right, remember, everyone has to start somewhere. Your first time doing anything is never going to be good, okay? I was never good at driving. I hit my mailbox the first time I was driving, but now I have a license, okay? So just keep at it, and just remember, you're going to get better, okay? Everyone starts off horrible, but then they get better with practice.
There we go, Sir Eddie. Any comment for all of our students logged in?
Yeah, nice push, guys. Just appreciate the things around you, okay? And then don't forget to answer that question, why my life is great, because why? And there's many reasons why, so I know you guys can think of one. It can be your dog or whatever it is, so just stay positive, because I see you guys out there.
Okay, so my final message for today, remember, it's Friday. Even though every day feels like a Tuesday or a Wednesday, I'm just getting all mixed up. Okay, I want you guys to remember this thing, okay, for like the rest of your life. Things don't matter, people matter. Okay, so I want you guys to understand, like a lot of us have a lot of things. I want you to understand that things don't matter, people matter. Okay, like just I want you guys to really practice that for the rest of your life. Okay, so remember, like I have a lot of things, but I don't really care about my things. I loan my stuff to everybody all the time. My things mean nothing to me. Guys, it means nothing to me. I have a lot of stuff. Okay, I want you to tell you that none of my things matter to me. I can lose it all tomorrow, and I'd be okay with it. I wouldn't even shed a tear. I wouldn't care about it, because things don't matter. The only thing that I really care about is people. That's the only thing that matters to me. So I want you guys to learn that. Practice it. None of your things should matter to you. The only thing that should matter to you are people. Okay? And with that, we're done. Okay? Great job today. Great job today. Sir Dale's
reminding us to measure his
hand. Oh, well, thank you for the reminder. I got a little carried away.
That was Chloe
Petrito. Chloe! Woo! Thanks for the reminder. That was also a senior moment. It's going to happen to you all. Watch, okay? The struggle is real. All the moms and dads, boom, high five. You guys know what I mean. The struggle is real, okay? Okay, so Sir Dale, come on over here, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so, don't forget, if you took the 4 o'clock class, you guys are not allowed,
don't message each other.
Don't mess it up for the kids that this is their first time, okay? Okay, so now, right now, remember, Man Nicole is live. Start typing in what you think Sir Dale's ponytail weighs. So, boom, oh, there it is. Okay, so, I'm making sure the scale's not touching his body. Remember, it's not his body. We're not weighing his body. On the 4 o'clock class, we had someone put like 200 pounds. First of all, he's not that big. Secondly, he's not 200 pounds. His hair is not 200 pounds.
A lot of them got it.
Just his ponytail. Keep typing. What do you guys think it weighs? Just his ponytail. 5 more seconds. Type it in. 4 more seconds. Type it in. 3 more seconds. Type it in. 2 more seconds. Type it in. 1 more second, type it in, and time! Boom! Okay, so, I'm gonna put this away. We all know how much it weighs. It weighs the same thing. Maybe it may weigh like a little feather less this time. Boom! What is it?
The two winners were Siddharth and Mai Mai. I mean, a lot of them said it, but the two first ones were Siddharth.
The first two people that typed their name, the rate in, even though there's a bunch of you that got it right, Siddharth and who else? Mai Mai? And Niana. You guys were the first two. What did you guys type in? 0.3 pounds. Yay! Great job. If you guys guessed 0.3 pounds, you are correct. If you were a little bit off, that's okay. It was just a game, right? So we're going to try to make Fridays like, you know, like fun and a little bit more loose and like a little more casual. Okay, we're still going to work out on Fridays. Like sometimes we're going to use like more weights because I want you guys to understand like how strong you really are or are not, right? So by using like, you know, like weights and stuff, you guys will realize how strong you really are. Okay, so great job today. I'm really proud of you guys. I know Sir Eddie's really proud of you guys. Everyone here at Shin, Sir Dell, Ma'am Nicole, Sir Ryan, Sir Eduardo, Ma'am Milani, we're all so proud of you. We miss you guys a lot. Okay, stay fit, stay healthy here in your mind. Okay, be nice to your parents.
Your siblings.
Okay, and your siblings, be nice. Everyone's a little edge. Be nice to everybody. This is the time to be nice to everybody. Okay, here we go. Ready? And feet together, hands up. And chair up, feet together, bow. Here we go. Ready? Fist in the middle. Good. Sir Dale's going to do the chair today.
Loud shins on three. One, two, three.
Shins. Good. We'll see you guys on Monday.